Hello, I am Bruce Rose and I work at CUI. My role here at CUI is to provide technical support for all of the CUI products to our customers and to our internal employees.
Can you explain the primary differences between the different overvoltage categories?
The overvoltage categories are established to differentiate applications based upon the severity of the voltage transients that will be present on the input terminals. The least severe category is OVC I, where the input is not directly connected to the power grid and thus should experience only mild input voltage transients. The most stringent category is OVC IV, where the product is connected directly to the external power grid and will experience the most severe input voltage transients. The general idea is the voltage transients present on the power distribution grid will be attenuated as the power is distributed throughout the power wiring within a building.
In what types of applications or environments would you primarily find OVC III power supplies and why?
Power supplies in OVC III applications will be hardwired into the power system. Many applications requiring OVC III protected supplies are found in industrial and business applications. An application found in the home and business locations that requires OVC III protection is level 2 EV chargers. The installation of the level 2 chargers will often require the input of the charger to be hardwired to the home or business AC power cabling, and in the case of home installations, the connection will normally be made close to the input power panel.
How is CUI making strides in this product category?
CUI does offer a broad range of power solutions and continuously monitors the market demands to ensure we provide appropriate products. In the case of OVC III, the popularity of electric vehicles has created a huge demand for level 2 chargers in the home, in apartment complexes, and at commercial and office buildings. Most of these charger designs require OVC III rated power supplies, and thus CUI is releasing products to meet this demand. This offering of more supplies with OVC III input protection is a business decision based upon market demands and is not limited by technical or engineering issues.
So how do you see the future of OVC III power supplies evolving, especially with the rise of renewable energy systems and smart grids?
That is a growing sector, and there will be increasing demand for power supplies with OVC III level protection as more renewable energy and smart grid installations and applications are implemented. The renewable energy and smart grid installations will require monitoring and control functions to be associated with each power source or power grid section. These monitoring and controlling functions will require supplies with OVC III protection because they will often be located close to the external power grid and hardwired into the power distribution network.
Thank you, Bruce. To learn more about CUI's overvoltage power supplies, visit Mouser's website.